A little over 3 years ago, Emily Corson made the decision to attend Piedmont College and play women's soccer. Little did she know that just 2 years later, she would make that choice again, this time to return to Piedmont.
I think my freshman year was honestly my favorite year out of all my years, just because I had so much success, friendship-wise, academically, and on the field. Friendship-wise, made friends with both the men's team and the women's team, and we're all still really good friends. So it's kind of like a family. So I came in and instantly had those bonds. And then academically, it just did really well with all those study hall hours we had to do. But then athletically, I had a really good first season, the best I could ever hope for coming in as a freshman. I was a regular starter. I got an honorable mention at the end of the season. So that was just a really good way to kind of have a good experience all around.
I think when she came in, she was one of the only out-of-state kids we had in the team at that time. She's from Tampa, a long way from home.
Obviously, I missed my family. It was a big change going, you know, from Florida to Georgia. But I kind of wanted that in a college. But I think a lot of people come into college expecting what they see in the movies, and that I was one of those. And so I went to a small private school for high school, so I kind of felt like I wasn't getting a different experience here. So that was one of the big reasons why I went to Fort Atlantic down in Florida. And I was by the beach, and I definitely had like the movie experiences, but something was missing. And I was on the club soccer team, but the intensity that I was used to from freshman year wasn't there. So I just felt like I was going through the motions, but something was still missing. My decision to come back was kind of spur of the moment and random. I was sitting in the kitchen with my mom, and I was just kind of telling her how I wasn't really happy at my new school. And she suggested that I go back to Piedmont. And I was like, I can't do that. Like, nobody ever transfers back to like where they left. And then after we talked about it more, she was like, you know, you loved it there. You missed soccer. You missed your friends. Like, why not? So I was like, all right. I emailed Petey with just a one-line sentence. And I was like, will you take me back?
It's probably one of the weirdest kind of recruiting experiences I've dealt with. It was the middle of the summer, I got an email, and there was no subject. But I thought it was like a spam email, someone hacked her email, and opened the email and it said, will you have me back? ? And that was it. So I emailed her back and I said, it's probably something you need to call me about, because I wasn't sure if it was a joke or what was going on. And she called me about an hour later and said, well, I made a mistake. I miss Piedmont, I want to be back. I've visited 3 or 4 times since I've transferred back to Florida. And then she can just get the process started again.
He was so supportive, and he was like, we have a big freshman class coming in, but you always have a spot. So I was really fortunate to have a good year freshman year, so that I was able to easily come back and have his acceptance. So coming back was kind of a mixture of a sense of relief, but also nerves. Coming back on campus was like I never left. There was kind of a weight lifted off my shoulders. But then coming back onto the field was a different story. I stayed in shape, but my touch was completely gone. I was kind of freaking out.
I knew she was good because she'd been all-conference player her freshman year, but she really struggled with that first week or so, and it took her about maybe a month to get back in the swing of things. I think she got confidence back pretty quickly after the first 2-3 weeks, but through that first week, I didn't think she'd make it. I thought she'd be back in a bus or a train or something, go back to Florida as soon as she could.
Coming back to the team was kind of an odd transition because I didn't know how to present myself to the sophomore class, and then I didn't want to sound like a know-it-all to the freshmen, like, oh yeah, I'm back, whatever. So that was interesting, but again, everyone was so supportive and they were like, oh, you never left, like, you're still part of the team.
Since family is important to Corson, earlier this season, she had a special weekend. Her family was able to travel to Demarest to watch her in action for the green and gold.
So my family has always been supportive. I mean, my dad loves that I play college soccer, and my grandpa, they're my biggest fans. So they were really excited that I made the decision to come back. But it was really special having a lot of my family here this weekend, because my one grandpa hasn't seen me play since I was like 5 years old. So it was a really special experience to have him come up and see me play college soccer. Coming back, it really influenced me more academically, Obviously, I love them playing soccer, but I think the smaller classrooms and the teachers and the attention you get from Piedmont was a much better suited for me than the big school. It sounds really cheesy, but the grass isn't always greener on the other side. I think a lot of people look at what their friends or maybe a relationship is telling them what to do, but as long as you follow your heart and you do what you love, then you're going to get the college experience that you want.
If she hasn't started every game since she's been back, she'd come off the bench, she's got significant minutes. She's definitely someone that's going to be really tough to replace for next year. But I'm really thankful she came back. She's helped us to have she's had a good 3 years with us. So it'll be nice to recognise her on Sunday for Senior Day. Yeah, I'm coming home.